In this example, we are given that in Kunz tube experiment, a brass rod of length 1 meter is used with average length of loop in air is 10.3 centimeter and that in carbon dioxide is 8 centimeter. We are required to find the speed of sound in brass and in carbon dioxide, and it is given that the speed of sound in air is 350 meters per second. We already studied the application of Kunz tube for comparison of a speed of sound. Here we know well that as brass rod is given that of length 1 meter, then we can write lambda of sound in brass can be written as 2 meter, as lambda by 2 is 1 meter. Similarly, lambda in air can be taken as 10.3 multiplied by 2, it is 20.6 centimeter. And lambda in carbon dioxide will be 8 into 2, this is 16 centimeter. These are the wavelengths experimentally measured in Kunz tube for speed of sound in brass, air and carbon dioxide. And as we know, the frequency remains constant, though frequency in brass is frequency in air is equals to frequency in carbon dioxide. So, we can simultaneously write the speed in brass by lambda in brass is equals to speed in air by lambda in air is equals to speed in carbon dioxide by lambda in carbon dioxide. As for all propagations, the speed remains constant. So, from here we can easily get the value of speed in brass, speed of sound in brass, which can be given as speed in air multiplied by lambda in brass upon lambda in air. If we substitute the values, this will be 350 multiplied by 2 by it is 20.6, so it can be written as 0.206. On calculation, this will give us 3400 meters per second. That will be one answer of this problem. Similarly, speed in carbon dioxide can be given as speed in air multiplied by lambda in carbon dioxide by lambda in air. Here, if we substitute the values, this is 350 multiplied by speed in carbon dioxide, we can calculate as V air into lambda CO2. Lambda CO2 is 16 centimeter, 0.16 by lambda air can be written as 0.206. On calculation, we'll get 271.8 meters per second. That is another answer to this problem.